dying.
Been waiting for you.
It took a while, but I got what you wanted.
Oh, so you have actually done it.
So, how is that stuff gonna prove your theories?
Yes, a test of sorts. I shall take this sample and eat it.
Did you just say eat?
That beast came from outside this world. It is not part of the warped time in which humanity now lives. It has something that we, with our ageless lives, now lack. Thus I theorize that by eating of its flesh and making it one with my own, I may be able to escape my timeless state. I trust you understand the implications.
You had me hunt this thing down, and now you want to eat it? All so that you can grow old again?
Precisely. I wish to age and die, as was once normal for humans. I'll finally be able to experience it for myself, to feel as this body, unchanged for 500 years, finally withers, life fleeing at last.
So you want to die of old age?
I want to experience everything life has to offer. I was lucky enough to be born and to live. Why wouldn't I wish to also grow old and die?
I suppose, if you look at it that way. Aging and dying don't seem too bad.
No, they don't. The only thing I fear is the taste. It looks terrible.
You better savor every bite. Another of life's experiences.
Of course. I truly do appreciate this boon.
So you knew who I was?
I could tell at once that you have joined this world from another time. Please accept my most sincere gratitude. Now my next task. I must research how to best cook and consume the flesh of the beast that you hunted for me. I plan to fully experience everything this world has to offer.
Death.
Do you dream of death? More and more new bandits are crawling out of the woodwork.
My father is very successful in Usnal. Do you think there's any kind of treasure here that could still impress someone like me?
You think I should just use that warp machine to get to the ruins? It won't suck out my soul or nothing, right?
For myself, I'd really like to uncover some treasure that no one's ever seen before.
The revenge you always wanted is complete.
You did it! You got revenge for me!
Do you feel better now?
Yes. I suppose I do.
That's the way revenge goes.
Yeah, you're probably right. But at least it saved me from pickling myself to death.
You're done grieving?
I'll never stop grieving. But I feel like I can face the grief head on now. I'm gonna go visit their grave and tell my kids about this.
Chewed out in the ruins, can you believe it?
It'll whip you off in a...
I owe you, Lightning. Thanks to you, I finally got a role to play here in the gang.
Thank you. Require a... Come again, anytime.
You used to cover high-profile stories. I'm investigating a story for a friend. Do you know anything about a man named Renolf?
Renolf? Yes, I think I do. Yes, the poor man's wife and daughter were brutally murdered over some business dispute. He lost everyone he loved in the blink of an eye.
That's some memory you have. This happened centuries ago.
My boss put me in charge of that story. It's one that's hard to forget.
That's lucky for us. Renolf himself asked me to look into the case, so he can know the truth. Do you think you can help?
Actually, I think I might be able to do just that. I can hardly refuse any favors from you now, can I? Except, I wonder if you wouldn't mind doing something for me in exchange.
You already owe me.
Just hear me out, please. You're helping all kinds of people, aren't you? Would you keep doing that, but when you're done, come tell me their stories.
Just their stories? Are you sure that's all you want from me?
Yes, I want to write something that will inspire people and lift their spirits. What better subject than you?
I've done what you asked.
I knew you could do it. This will make a fantastic article.
I'm not one to preach morality, but doesn't that violate some sort of reporter ethics? Writing stories that you helped create?
The job of a reporter is to follow the truth, and that's what I'm doing. But if we're being completely honest, the real reason I asked for that favor isn't for a story. My real purpose was to observe you and watch you in action.
I'm scared!
What do you mean? Why me?
I know who you are now. You help people, and in doing so, you save their souls. That's the duty you've been assigned by you-know-who upstairs. You are the savior, aren't you?
Huh. You knew who I was all along.
Let's just say I had a hunch. But don't worry. Your secret will be safe with me. I won't tell anyone. Oh, by the way, I looked into Renolf's past. I found something that might be helpful. The case was cold for a long time. But it turns out they did find a suspect in the end.
So, was he arrested?
I don't know if this is good news or not, but the person in question appears to have passed away some time ago. Once the authorities saw the death certificate, they stopped the investigation.
You're right. I don't know if that's good or bad news. So who was the person behind this?
Some lowlife that was part of a criminal organization, specialized in petty crime. But he was a wily little rat. He managed to stay one step ahead. He went through aliases, but the one on the death certificate was Reddick.
Reddick? I met someone with the same name in the Warren. He said he'd been in hiding for a long time.
Could it be the same man? Is it possible he's still alive? But there was a death certificate and everything.
He mentioned that he was dead in the eyes of the law. And he also knew where Renolf's journal was.
Do you think he managed to fake his own death by forging the document to escape the order's scrutiny? Then it looks like the case has been solved. We found our man. I'll go through the records again, in case we missed something.
It was Reddick, the man in the Warren with no name. Are you gonna tell Renolf about this?
I'm
it really was Riddick, there's something I want to ask him first. Let's go to the Warren and see if he'll talk. Nothing I can't handle.
Return to the city.
I thought they did away with the military.
Welcome to our... We eagerly await your next visit.
You really want to see the tears of an angel, don't you? I'm so sorry. I know this is getting old, but I don't think I can sell them to you after all.
Look, if you can't sell me any, why don't you just tell me in the first place?
Well, let me ask you this. Why do you insist on buying them when they're not what you're after in the first place? I know deep down, you really want something else.
You're a mind reader too?
Don't be coy. It's just that I can read people sometimes. I can sense what they're after.
Look at you, blessed with all these hidden talents.
No need to be snide. What you're after is... is gone. Never to return. You lost something that was dear to you. An irreplaceable bond of some kind.
Who the hell are you?
I'm just a kid that's always been a little bit more perceptive than others, that's all. For some reason, I can sense what people want and how they're feeling. My tears are therapeutic for them.
I don't understand how it is that your tears can help people with their problems.
Well, everyone's been alive for so long now, their hearts are old and worn. They don't know how to feel anymore. Their tears have all dried up. People have lived for so long with feelings of sorrow and despair that it's become a natural part of them now. They don't even notice it anymore. They can't cry because they've forgotten how. That's why I do it for them. When people see my tears, it helps them remember how they used to feel. I think people should be able to laugh when they're happy and cry when they're sad.
The angels' tears you sell mend people's hearts. I'll admit, that's admirable.
I believe you can't smile a genuine smile without being able to cry genuine tears. I just help them remember what it's like. But I can't heal you with my tears. That's why I don't cry for you. Sorry.
Then what about you? Do you ever cry for yourself to mend your own heart?
Huh? For me? No, I haven't done that in a long time.
At least not for centuries, I'm guessing.
I think so. Why do you ask?
Just curious. She heals people by crying for those who can't, but she can't cry for herself. Her tears have become nothing more than a tool for her trade, an item to sell. No one seems to notice that, like everyone else, her heart needs healing too.
Hotel. We eagerly await your next visit.
Now that I have Renolf's journal, I know who was behind the murders of his wife and child. You've been running ever since. You even faked your own death.
I knew someone would make me. You got me. So you know everything. Yeah, I did it. I killed his family. I took the lives of his beautiful wife and daughter. All for a little money. The one who hired me had a rival business, and he wanted Renolf out of the game. He's long gone, though. Passed away some time ago.
After you took care of business for this man, did you also steal the journal?
Again, that was me. Years after the incident, something happened to Renolf. One day, he just seemed to forget the whole thing ever happened. I thought it was a lucky break on my part. I figured it was the best thing for all of us.
But why didn't you just dispose of it? It would have been easier than giving it to someone for safekeeping. And if it links you to the crime, why help me find it?
Guilt. I was too much of a coward to turn myself in, but I think I was waiting for someone to figure it out. I'm tired of running. Turn me in, arrest me, do what you want.
It's not up to me to decide your punishment.
So be it. I'll be right here waiting for retribution. Hey, I know you don't owe me anything, but do me a favor, will you? Don't tell my son about this, okay? That's all I ask.
Who's your son?
Name's Marlin. He's my stepson. A good kid. He's nothing like me. Got his own business and everything.
Marlin? He's not a baker by any chance, is he?
You know him? Even though I'm not his real father, he sends me money on a regular basis. You know, to get by. He has a good heart. I couldn't ask for a better son. I really don't deserve a boy like him.
Light, isn't Marlin the boy Renolf is so fond of? The one who bakes him those muffins that he loves so much?
This does complicate things, but Renolf insisted he wants to know the truth, and that's what I'm gonna give him.
Really? Even though something like this could ruin their friendship? Do you think Renolf's prepared for that, after losing his family all over again?
chaos takes away.
You again?
last as long. Together, we can prevail!
This feels familiar.
I hope you can make everyone's wishes come true.
Something from a thief who's passed out drunk. Is that really a crime?
Hurry up, folks, before...
How long you want to take a rest?
There you are. Welcome home. What's wrong?
Nothing, just things on my mind. Don't worry about it.
I can't help but worry. We're finally getting the chance to talk, but you don't seem happy. It's like you don't even know how to smile anymore.
Right now, this is the best I can do. Not that I was ever good at it.
It's okay. I can make you smile again. You just have to go back to the days when the future still looked bright.
When was that?
back before we made all those mistakes. Before we started messing around with gods and Falci. We thought it was our destiny to fight for the world and the future. But all those battles, all those struggles, they didn't mean anything in the end.
Was it all a mistake? Even the journey you went on with Mara?
Well, what else would you call it? We risked everything, but in the end, we couldn't save the future, and I died. If that's not a mistake, what is? That's why I have to get rid of it. Throw it all away. It didn't mean a thing. It's done and gone. No regrets, just a clean slate. We're going to have a new world, and you and I will be just like we used to be way back when.
Listen, Sarah. Let me say this. If that journey was a mistake, I'm the one who has to bear the blame, because I sent you. It's me who has to pay the price. All you did was try your best. There's nothing wrong with that. It didn't turn out like I'd hoped, but it wasn't a mistake. You tried to do something that was good and right. You must never throw that away.
Maybe. But I don't want to remember it again. I just want to forget it all.
Right. When she said that, I didn't believe her. She'd always been able to accept hardship, fight through it, and be stronger for it. Lumina's words came back to me. She said the only fake I know is Sarah. No, that couldn't be right. The problem was in me, making me doubt her. But it was no good. The terrible thought had formed in my mind. The seed was planted. What if this Sarah was fake? And my memories of her too. Give us a reprieve so that I can save more souls.
Are you doing okay, Light? What do you think Fang is going to do now? Will she try to break into the Order's cathedral?
I met Lumina again.
You mean the girl who walks in the chaos? That would explain the chaos readings I picked up in the Ark. She brings the chaos with her. Light, there's something that bothers me about that girl. Perhaps you've noticed it as well.
You mean how she looks just like Sarah at that age?
So you think so too. They're so alike. I can't help thinking that it really is her, in some way.
She may look like Sarah, but it's not her. Lumina's just too different. And she really rubs me the wrong way.
Maybe she's not that bad. Just that her behavior seems all the worse when she looks so much like your sister. In any case, for now, Lumina's real identity will remain a mystery.
I saw her again. My sister. It looks like God might keep his promise and bring my sister back. She'll be a new Sarah.
New? What do you mean by that? Are you saying that when he resurrects Sarah, it will be a different person? Like, a fake?
No, that's not it at all. I just mean, if she's going to be born again, she'll be a new version of her old self.
I don't think you're being straight with me, are you? You don't think the Sarah you met is the real thing, do you? You think that there's something missing. It's all right. You don't have to say anything. The truth is plain enough to see. Since I came here, I haven't been good at reading people, but I've been practicing on you. But don't worry, I'm on your side. Yours and Sarah's. You know that, right? You only agreed to become the savior because it was your only chance to save Sarah. And that means God has a hold on you. But if the Sarah he's showing you isn't real, then that control he has disappears. He has no hostage.